Hi, I'm Jason Locke. I'm asking for your vote for Lawrence County Probate Judge. I am a lifelong resident of Lawrence County. My family and I are active members of Dudley Baptist Church, and I'm currently the mayor of the city of Dudley. I've been a board member of the Boys and Girls Club. I'm a former president and continue to serve as a board member of Dublin Lawrence Crime Stoppers. I serve on the school council for West Lawrence High School. I'm an active exchangeite, and I've been the president of Dudley Little League since 2011. I seek God's will every day for my life. My education in criminal justice, my 20 years of experience in municipal through superior court systems throughout the area, and my extensive community involvement has allowed me to meet many people and make a difference in many lives. Leadership is about relationships. I promise to serve with wisdom and integrity. I'm Jason Locke, and I want to be your next Lawrence County Probate Judge.
Matt Hatchett has been honored to serve the people of District 150 for the past 9 years, serving parts of Lawrence, Troutman, and Johnson counties. And being a small business owner for many years, Matt understands the importance of low taxes, good infrastructure, and jobs. Matt and his wife Kim support and have been involved in the St. Patrick's Festival for many years and encourage everyone to get out and be a part of the 55th Annual Dublin Lawrence St. Patrick's Festival. Erin Gobrah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are at the Gala, and we are having an excellent time this evening. We're caught up with Piper McAfee. Piper, now you've been real busy today.
Yeah, we have been getting ready for the Gala. I've been at two different pageants and all over Dublin, just spreading the season of green.
Hey, you're spreading that green, and throughout that pageant, we had, 77 contestants this year. You get to see a lot of young ladies from babies on up.
Oh, yes. They were so cute, and the ladies were just absolutely beautiful. It was a great way to really start the season.
Yeah, one of the first responsibilities of Miss St. Patrick's.
Yeah, and she looked beautiful, too. It's just so sparkly and wonderful.
Yeah, good job every single year. This year, the gala is much earlier.
Yes,
we
are leaping into St. Patrick's on Leap Day today, February 29th, and we are excited to kick off the St. Patrick's season here in Dublin.
It's real exciting. A lot of people will turn out and be enjoying tonight. If you missed it this year, you certainly want to put it on your calendar for next year. But a lot of great activities coming, right?
Definitely. Dozens of them, and we're ready to get started.
Yeah, don't forget to go on the website on the screen. You can check out more information.
Yep.
Like it on Facebook. Tell your friends and neighbors and come on out. The committee's doing a great job
Thank you.
Have a great time tonight.
Thanks so much, you too.
All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, when I think of Dublin, you are definitely one of the people that I think of as a leader in Dublin, as an example of what a Dublinite is, Jeff. You've been active in this community since you were a little boy.
Right.
You've told me some stories over time, and I've heard them from other people as well, about how you've worked so tirelessly in the community. Your parents believed in this town,
right,
didn't they?
Right. That's, my mom and dad were, they were just community people. My mom was a little bit more out front. You saw her because of what she did. My dad did things that you never knew he was doing.
Yeah.
So.
Kind of a silent warrior there.
Right.
But what, you take your hat off to people like that every day who do so much in our community, who don't ask for anything. And then there are those who like to be out in front and do it to
That's right.
So you got a great new location downtown.
We do.
Jeff, you're enjoying it, aren't you?
We are. We are.
You got a skip in your step when I see you walking up and down the sidewalk in downtown. That's great. It's so wonderful to be able to enjoy our town again.
It is. We were just to be part of the revitalization of downtown, just to be down here and see what's happened. It's just incredible.
Yeah, so we have the awards banquet coming up really quickly. You know, we'll be recognizing several leaders in our community. That's always a thrill to me, especially one award that's after your mom.
Right.
Which really means a lot to you, I know, Jim.
It does, because that award, basically the merit of that award is that you've given to this festival tirelessly for, I'm trying to think, it's at least 15 years.
Yeah.
And, you know, there are people that have been doing this for 30 or 40 years.
Time flies,
they're always here. So
yeah.
Yeah. There's a lot of people that are deserving of that.
And you're doing the same, Jeff. Again, hats off to you. Again, when events take place in Dublin, you're going to be there. You're going to be a part of it.
Right.
You're a good example. So, ladies and gentlemen, anytime you want to talk to somebody about how to get involved in Dublin, you can call on Jeff Cannon. He'll get you involved.
We'll sign you up.
All right. But 2020, Jeff, 55 years here we've been at St. Patrick's Festival. We were little kids that started.
Right. I was in the leprechaun contest back in the day. Way back in the day.
Most of us have a good story
right,
on that.
Right.
And so we want to see you involved in everything. If you didn't make it out to the gala this year, you want to make it next year, won't you, Jeff?
That's right.
It's a great addition to the St.
Right.
Patrick's Festival.
Exactly.
Thanks
exactly.
again for what you do. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, this is Eddie and Tracy Schrader. If you don't know them already from our community, been a large part of our community for a while. Now, Tracy, let's talk about your grandkids first.
Well, Ron, you know I have a lot to say about those grandchildren. Yes.
I'm real proud of them.
I'm so proud of them. They are the light of my life, that's for sure. So, yes.
You're a very family-oriented person, and you care about the community, both of you do. You're quite
Absolutely.
Involved. Now, you've been an ambassador for the last couple of years
for
the Chamber of Commerce, right?
Four years. And was fortunate enough, I just wanted to volunteer for this, and was fortunate enough they asked me to be president of the Order of Shillelagh. I was like, whoa, you know, wait.
Yep.
I wanted to get my toes wet, but they threw me in there. So
yep.
I said, okay, let's go.
Well, they know what kind of worker and what kind of guy you are, Eddie. You don't meet a stranger, you never have.
I love people.
I love people.
And Dublin has reached out to me and been so good to me, and I just feel like I need to give back and make the community better for my family and to show people around to come live in Dublin. This is a great place to raise a family. We got things happening. You know, keep it going.
Yeah, it's never too late to become a member of the order, is it?
It's not. Never too late.
Yeah. So they can get in touch with you anytime?
Anytime. You call me on my cell tonight, be fine. I'll take your money, no problem.
A lot of dancing going on now. Which one of y'all like to dance the most?
I love it.
So don't light that. That's all I'm going to tell you.
No,
it's a
don't
no smoking
that.
Environment.
No, I'm
the only thing we're going to light tonight is the floor.
I love it. Have a great time. Thanks
great.
For speaking.
Thanks, Ron.
Hey, how you doing? Eric Kate City.
I'm good.
Brad Grimes.
I think I'm smelling some gas in my yard out here.
All right. And what area are you smelling now?
Over here in this area, the meter's on that side over there.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to check the meter, make sure there's not a leak there.
Okay.
Then we'll locate the line out and put down a couple holes just to check on the ground to make sure you don't have a leak. We'll check each corner of your house. If you could, just stay on the porch.
Okay.
If you think you have a gas leak, we're on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Call us at 478-277-5048.
Products and installation since 1985. That's four seasons.
Dublin Nissan might be the best kept secret in Middle Georgia.
And we have state-of-the-art technicians like John Lowry, who's been with us for over 36 years.
The Altima, sporty and affordable.
I'm Henrietta Williams here at Dublin Nissan. I've been here for 25 years. For your best deal in town, come see me.
Save gas and money with a Sentra.
We live here and we work here, and we love to give back to Heart of Georgia United Way.
Dublin Nissan, the only dealer you will ever need.
Lawrence County's leader in hometown banking is Farmers State Bank. From our customer service professionals to our mortgage specialist or any of our professional lenders, we're committed to making banking as easy as FSB. Farmers State Bank, with locations in Dublin and Caldwell, member FDIC and an equal housing lender. Stop by today and find out why we make banking as easy as FSB.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we made our way around to Miss Souvenir Queen.
Absolutely.
Rick's, and you have always brought the souvenirs and showed up well.
I try to do it everywhere we go.
Somebody told me if I cut you, you'd bleed green.
I do.
Yes, ma'am. And I love it. You just all the way in the entire. I love the 20s theme and the gala that we've started to do over the last couple of years.
We've enjoyed that.
Second, third year running here. Second year running here.
Yeah.
And what a great time it is. You come and you set up in the front. Do you sell a lot of souvenirs at this event?
Well, not really. A lot of times we just show them. And I show very limited things at this particular one. Only things that we can get them to buy after they've had a drink or two.
So you came to dance.
There you go. And most of them do.
Well, it's coming up on time for some thrilling events. One is painting the streets.
All right, now, Monday at 9 o'clock, we'll be downtown, weather permitting, and painting shamrocks, and we'll start downtown in front of the courthouse with the big shamrock and work our way down. The police department and the fire department are wonderful to help us do that. And then it just works real well, and that's just a thing we started doing a number of years ago. In fact, we used to do it after the grand ball at 3 o'clock in the morning in tuxedos and evening gowns, but we did get a little more casual than that.
Hey, it was fun times.
It was a fun time.
What a great tradition when you see those lining down, you freshen up the ones that just seem to last and last. It really makes you proud to be a part of Dublin.
It really does.
So I know you get out and you enjoy virtually every event that we have, don't you?
Nearly every one. I don't sell souvenirs at every single one because there's some that, like little kid things, parents are interested in kids. They're not interested in souvenirs, and they get them somewhere else at other times. But we have souvenirs at nearly every event.
Yeah. Most every year we have a new one, a new souvenir, don't we?
Well, we have a new long sleeve t-shirt, which we haven't had in a number of years, and we've got a beautiful new short sleeve t-shirt. Since this is leaping into new year, they're following us to the Emerald City, and we've got the new painted plates again, which added the Henry Building.
Awesome.
So we did add a new thing to our painted plates, and that's a good seller for us.
We better jump on into the gala, right?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. You know, one of the reasons I enjoy St. Patrick so much and living in Dublin, Georgia, is you, Denise. You are an example of what a good person is, a community person. Not only in what you do in work every day, but all the extra things you do for our community, the things you volunteer for. You've been a part of St. Patrick's Festival for many years, haven't you?
Since 2010.
2010.
Yes,
rocking
10 years.
Right on along.
Yes, that's it.
And you put in a decade of work.
Yes. It is.
And sometimes it feels like it, sometimes it doesn't.
It's like, oh, this month we'll never get through. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, no, I miss my friends.
Yeah. So some of your favorite events, let's talk about those.
Well, let's see. I like arts and crafts.
Yeah.
And I like the Munchies since we brought it back.
Oh, I
We're
love
glad
that
it brought that back. And, of course, you know, I like Easter Seals Golf Tournament.
Oh, yeah, I know that.
We have to get that in there.
Yep.
So,
we appreciate everybody who takes part in that golf tournament every year. You have a lot of teams sign up for that, a lot of support for it. It all goes to a very worthwhile cause,
as
grown, you know.
We have grown it a lot.
Yeah.
So,
good thing. Keep it growing, ladies and gentlemen. You'll find these all over town. You'll find a brochure for the 55th Annual St. Patrick's Festival. You pick you up one, and don't miss any events. This is one that you've enjoyed, I know, since last year.
Yes.
Heard so much about it last year. I'm just so proud to be down here this evening and be able to enjoy this gala. And look at the food, the spread.
Hey, and what about
there.
The band?
The band.
The band is rocking,
it.
Yeah.
Already. Usually it takes a little while for it to warm
them.
Up, but not this one.
No.
Yep. So put it on your calendar each and every year now as the gala is going to continue to be a part of our St. Patrick's activities and so many other ones. But
thanks
again,
so
Denise,
appreciate
thank you.
You
for what you do.
I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're having a good time down at the gala. And Royce, what a great event it is. Last year was the first year. Second year, it seems to get better.
Right. I just say the first sequel is always a good one, and the second one is even better. And this year's theme is Leaping to St. Patrick's 2020.
And then
we're having a time of our life again, part two. So we are glad that to be here and just to see everybody having a great time once again.
Yeah.
Part two.
Yep. And it's a good time. You were out and about today. You've been out and about for a few days. We crowned Miss St. Patrick's last week or so. And then, you know, right on along with Emerald City going on, or Miss Emerald City and the other pageants through the rec department today. But so much to look forward to. The awards banquet will be here before you know it.
Right.
It's just a ball all the time right now with St. Patrick's activities. But a lot of hard work went into it.
A tremendous amount of work. Matter of fact, probably from May of, I'm going to say April of last year. Well, we took a break from April. But from May, from last year to this point, it's been planning, planning, planning. And it takes that to make this community have a great, great festivity. And tonight is the kickoff. And today is happy, you know, St. Patrick's Day, the 29th day, leap into St. Patrick. So this is a leap year. So we're trying to kick off by leaping into St. Patrick's.
Yep. And so we want everybody to get a brochure, go online, check it out, get involved in all the activities that are coming our way. And thank you for all the hard work that you've done, Royce.
We love doing what we do, and that's making the community have a place to have a good time, to laugh. And I love seeing pictures with a lot of people having a great time, and that's what this is all about, you know, servitude and just everybody having a great time, coming together as a community. And we just love it. We just thank everybody for pitching in and just showing love for one another.
All right, we'll get back to the event. Thank you, Royce.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Larry Dean, Sheriff of Lawrence County. 4 years ago, we didn't have a crime suppression unit and we didn't have a canine unit. I'm proud to tell you today that we do have a canine unit and a crime suppression unit. Our crime suppression unit and our canine unit work hand in hand to eradicate drugs from the streets and roads of Lawrence County. We take drug dealers off the street every single week. Promises made, promises kept. I'm Larry Dean, and I approve this message.
St. Patrick's Festival. I can't believe it's 2020. It seems like just yesterday my children were small and were in the parades and the pageants.
I know, where's time gone? My kids were little and we used to celebrate, come to the leprechaun contest, go to the parade, just enjoy the day with family. I've got grandchildren now and I'm really looking forward to having fun with them.
Our community is so wonderful, has so much to offer. We have so many events year round. We would love to have you a part of our community. Whether you need a large home for a large family,
small home, downsizing,
give us a call. We'd love to help you find the perfect home in the perfect community.
I'm Jody Tanner.
I'm Pam Tillery.
And we are the TNT Group.